Welcome to this lecture. This is Vijay from Dino Code Academy. So in this lecture, we are going to add the audio assets inside our GoQuiz application. So what I mean, when the answer is correct, like Android is partitioned operating system, this is the correct answer. So when I click confirm, I want to play a correct audio sound. Along with that, when the answer is incorrect, like this one, and when I click confirm, then I want to play a wrong audio. So to do that, we need these two audio assets. The one is for correct, the other is for wrong. And they have the extension .ogg. So simply copy it and go to inside the Android Studio, click on the project tab, go to rest directory, and first you need to create a new raw directory. So simply go to Android resource directory, a dialog box will pop up, and from there you need to select the raw and hit OK. Now instead of that, simply by pressing Ctrl V, we are actually pasting the two assets that are audio assets, that is correct ogg and the wrong .ogg. So it's time to use it inside the Android activity, means our GoQuiz application. So first I'm going to close all the other files, and then I'm going to expand this Java directory, means a Java package, and right click it, and I'm going to create a new Java class which is used for play audio file. Then press OK. Now the file is created. Now instead of that, we are going to write the code, and I'm going to separate the code from the quiz activity. I can put it inside this quiz activity as well, but the quiz activity is already very heavy. I want to just only place a quiz logic and the UI related stuff. So that's the reason I create a separate Java class file that will play a audio depending upon the correct and the wrong answer. So first we need a context so that we can communicate with the activity. So here I will be using a private. Then we need to declare a context variable, then M, and then with the context semicolon, and after that we need to declare a media object, that is a media player object, because in Android we need to use a media player to play the audio or maybe a video. And here simply type media player and then semicolon. Then we need to generate a constructor so that when we create a object of this class inside the quiz activity, then we can't get error. So we just only need a context parameter, simply hit OK. So this is the constructor, now is created. It's time to create a new method. So here I will be typing a public, and this method is of type void, and the name of the method I'm going to set is set audio for answer to be more meaningful, and then this will accept a one parameter. So the parameter I'm going to specify is of type integer, and it's going to be a flag. Now the concept of this flag variable, you will know about it when I will use it inside the quiz activity in this video. Then make some room by pressing some enter key, and then here type a switch key. So first I'm going to use a switch key, then here type a flag, and then start with the, and then here need to specify the case 1. The case 1 is going to be, first we need to create an integer variable, and M correct audio. So this is a correct audio, is going to be equals to r dot, so it's actually stored in the raw file. So I'm going to type here raw dot and then the correct audio and then semicolon. Then we need to pass this to the method, that is, so first I'm going to specify the break, and then inside of that we need to create another method. So I'm going to type here play and music. So this method will accept the m correct as a parameter, that is m correct audio. And it is not created yet, so I'm going to alt plus enter it and create this method. Now this method is created, so I'm going to change the parameter list of this method to. So now the parameter is changed. It's time to specify the another case for the wrong audio. So simply type here case, then it's going to be the case 2. Then again need to create an integer local variable. Simply type here wrong. So m correct audio, instead of m correct audio, I'm just simply going to set the correct audio. And here simply type a wrong audio. Then initialize it into r dot raw, then with the help of wrong audio and then semicolon. After that, pass this parameter to the play music, and here simply type the wrong as a audio source. And then simply specify the break, not boolean, it's going to be break. So that's it for the case. Now come inside this play music method. So this is the music, or you can say that the audio, play audio, or maybe music, totally up to you how you want to name your method. So here first we need to type a media player, is equal to, and we need to specify, we need to create the media player by using MediaPlayer.create method and then specify the context. After specifying the context, press a tab key, then simply here set the audio file. So which is this audio file, and then specify the semicolon. After that, you need to set the listener, means MediaPlayer.set on prepared listener, which is specially used for in case of media player, and here type new and then again media player on prepared listener. It will complete the code for you. Then here simply specify the media player dot start. So simply set it and then it's okay. After that, after the end of this play music file, now inside of the play music file, we need to again, once the media player is completed, so we need to use a set on complete listener. Set on complete listener, here again specify the new media player on completion list, and instead of this method we want to release the media player, media player dot release, so that we can actually play another audio once the audio is played. That's all for the coding inside the play audio for answer. It's time to use it inside the quiz activity. So the process is almost same. First we need to declare the object at the global level. So here first we are going to declare the object. So in simply type a private, then play answer audio, mean play audio for answer is equal to not is equal to, then we need to clear the object, then semicolon, and after that we need to create the integer variable of type flag. So flag is going to be initialized to 0. Inside of the onCreate, we need to first allocate the memory to the object. So here is a play audio for answer, it's going to new, then play audio for answer, and then pass this as a context, then semicolon. So whenever the value flag variable is 1, we are going to set it inside the quiz check solution method. Then the 1 is passed to this switch statement, means it is passed to this method, and this method is called, here is 1. So then the case 1 is triggered, so it will play the correct audio. And when we pass it here 2, then the 2 values actually copied from here, and then it will comes to here, then it will execute the case 2. So this play audio method will be triggered. So this is the logic that I have used for playing the correct audio and wrong audio depending upon the quiz logic. Now it's time to use these two variables inside our check solution method. So I'm going to click on this project tab so that you can see everything clearly, and go to our check solution method. So this is our check solution method, and here when the condition is correct, means the correct dialog is appearing, after the end of the correct dialog, we are going to set the flag variable to actually 1, then semicolon, and after that we are going to pass this object to the set audio for answer, and then pass the flag. If it's a capital flag, so the parameter flag is passed to this method. I already explained you. Now I have to copy this code and paste it inside the case 2 if condition as well, and for the case 3 condition as well. Once answer is correct, then for the condition case 4 as well. And similarly, for we need to pass the flag 2 as a parameter to this so that we can trigger the wrong audio, and we are going to do that inside the else block for our wrong answer. So here type flag and initialize it into 2, then call the method play answer dot set audio source, and then here type the flag, then copy these two statements, copy it and paste it inside the else block, and also for the else block of case 2, then similarly for the else block of case 3. Now it's time to run the application to see that our code is working or not. So you are not going to hear the audio because I am using a headphone. So I'm just going to tell you that this is actually working. So simply I'm going to run it into my virtual emulator. So here you can see our application is now running. So when I click the game development and click confirm, correct. So it's actually saying the correct, and I'm hearing the audio, but you can't hear it because of the headphone that I'm using. So Chrome is what's a browser, but I'm selecting the tool. So believe me guys, the code is actually working. Now in the introduction lecture, you see that I'm running this application to my physical device as well. So it's actually working. Right now I'm not using the physical device because it's not actually working properly. My physical device is little damaged, so that's reason I'm not using it. So that's it for this lecture. The audio is actually playing. So the only thing is left, this time working code. So we're going to do that, the timer code, inside the next lecture. So that's it for this lecture. If you like this video, then share it with your friends, whoever want to develop the quiz application by using SQLite. And if you are new to my channel, then make sure you subscribe to my channel and also press the bell icon so that you can get a notification when I upload a new lecture. Thanks for watching and I will see you in the next lecture. Thank you.